Hello friends, today we'll see how we can paint a still life of pots, pans and droplets of water in watercolors. Please refer to my earlier videos on basic considerations of watercolor painting and some fundamental brush strokes, and also the individual videos on how to paint different types of objects. Once you know these, you will be in a better position to understand and repeat this video after watching it. Wish you all the best. Here we go. We begin with a wash of yellow in such a way that we preserve the white of all the white objects. This pan, I'm going to keep it white. This I'll color blue, this I'll color red, and this some other color. And these are the droplets of water which you are seeing here, which have been sketched in light pencil. And if you refer to my earlier videos on how to paint droplets of water in watercolor, you will be able to understand what I am doing here. I leave out all those parts which ought to be kept white till the end of the exercise. So I begin this way. I do a variegated wash of yellow and red for the background. So in this way, I paint variegated wash surrounding all the objects and the two droplets of water, and then allow this to dry completely. Now, presuming light striking from the top left side, I start painting the objects one by one. To show the shine or the object, I leave a large portion of white of the paper untouched. Then wash the brush, dry the brush, take clean water, flick the brush, and add a little moisture on the inner sides, allowing the color to just kiss that moisture and guide the color a little more and more till the white portion diminishes in size. And a tiny white of the paper is so left out that it resembles the shine over the object. So in this way, I am done with the first object. Now for the second object, I take orange. And paint a flat wash of orange all over. And in those areas where light strikes the most and bounces off, producing a beautiful shine, I leave that much paper white. Now, since this pan is going to be white, I carefully paint around that pan and complete the first layer of the orange object. The same holds good for the blue object, which will be kept inside the pan. Then I add some water and do some softening. The softening gives rise to the shine. Allow this to dry. Then I choose the next object and use cobalt blue, much in the same way as I have painted the earlier objects. Initially leaving a large area of white to produce the shine on this object. Now, after dyeing, we put some further details. Allow this to dry. Thank you. Now the white pan to be painted with the use of very dilute Payne's gray. Softening to be done here. Then continue on the other side of the pan. Apply some water and do some softening. Use the same paints gray to indicate the shadow and the little darker side of the white pan. Again, some water added and pull to the left side to complete the white pan. Again, allow this to dry. Now coming to the droplets of water, I touch a little bit of burnt sienna to the same yellow which I started off with, and I apply it at the extreme end of the droplet. The explanation to painting droplets of water have been given in one of my earlier videos on how to paint droplets of water in watercolors. Allow this to dry. Now we add shadows of all the objects with the help of a dilute Payne's gray. So that's it. A still life of pots and pans painted in transparent watercolors. Thank you very much for watching the video.